The Lord say so. Can we stand all over the house just for a moment? Let's give the Lord some praise. Thank God. And then we're not who we used to be anymore. He has washed us and cleaned us, redeemed us and saved us and hallelujah, sanctified us, filled us with the Holy Ghost, wrote our name down in the Lamb's Book of Life. Are you happy to be alive today? Are you happy to be called a child of God today? He has done so much for us. You know, and the Lord has done what nobody else could do. Nobody else in this world could do what Jesus has done for us. Nobody else could do it. It don't matter how good of a person they are. It don't matter how big of a name they have. It don't matter how much money people has. They cannot do what Jesus has done for us. Amen. And I think that deserves just to give the Lord some praise right there. God, we thank you and we praise you. Lord, you are worthy of all praise. You are worthy of all honor. You are worthy of all glory. Lord, the Bible said the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. And everyone who lived in it, God, we're your creatures. And today, we don't want to let a rock cry out in our place. We want to praise the living God. We want to worship you today, Lord. That's why we have come into your house with thanksgiving in our hearts and entering your courts with praise. Lord, just as we entered in last week into the Holy of Holies, God, I pray we enter in today as well. Lord, and to worship and to magnify you. God, you have done what nobody else could do. We thank you for that. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Can I get a couple volunteers to come up with us this morning? And we know we've already made mention of this. Yeah, we need a little one for the youth fund this morning. Who wants to? Come on up, Riley. You help us this morning? This will be for the youth fund. Praise God. And I want you to remember Sister Kelly Naramore, her mother, we done mentioned. I went home to be with the Lord. Then Sister Pam, that usually back here beside Aunt Virginia, she lost her mother. We done her funeral yesterday. So many that are hurting. Brother Bill, lift him up. So many. Sister Joyce. So I can't begin to call out all the names. I see so many empty seats. Sister Ronnie B. Sister Dawn.
Helen Trapp.
Helen Trapp. Just put in ICU on a ventilator. Is that your kin folks?
It's Leanne's sister.
It's Leanne's sister-in-law. All right. God, touch them. Touch them. If you have a need, would you just slip up your hand this morning? If you got more than one, you can raise them both. We're going to believe God to meet those needs. He is the problem solver. He is the answer to our problems. He is the way maker, the miracle worker. He is the one, hallelujah, that turns prayer requests into praise reports. And so we're wanting to believe that this morning. We're going to believe God to do great and mighty things. Brother Adam.
Got a surgery coming up Friday.
Sister Dana's got a surgery this Friday. Right. God, we're going to pray. And before we leave, we're going to have a special prayer. That be all right. Sister Tammy back there, we'll have special prayer with you. So many others. If you need prayer today, we want to touch and believe God for you today. So let's join in together right now in congregational prayer. Let's just believe God to meet every need in the house. And all the ones who are not here, God bless them. We wish they were here. But you know what? God can touch them there just like he can right here. So let's go to him in prayer this morning. Father, in the name of Jesus, the name that is above every name, God, we lift you up. And we're lifting up these needs to you, God. And we're coming before the throne room of grace. And we're asking for mercy and help in our time of need. God, be with the families who have lost their mothers and their loved ones this week, God. And for the ones who need a touch right now, touch them, Lord. The ones that are sick, God, move for them. Heal them, Lord. God, we lift up special prayer for all of our members here this morning, our family, Lord God, that are in desperate need of a touch from you, Lord. Touch them in a mighty way. For all the ones that are here, God, we pray a special touch upon them as well. Let nobody leave here, God, in want or in need, but let us walk out of here praising and glorifying you, God. For you make all things new. Your word says you make all things new. You are the great and living God, and in you we put our trust. We believe in the blood of Jesus has not lost its power. We believe the name of Jesus is the name above every name. And we believe, God, that what you done 2,000 years ago, when you sacrificed yourself on the cross for us. But 3 days later, Lord, you come out of the tomb and you rose triumphantly with the keys of death, hell, and the grave in your hand. And you come out victorious. And Lord, because you overcame, your word says that now we are overcomers. Lord, anybody with doubt in their mind this morning, I pray, touch that. Touch them, Lord, and give them an assuring faith. Give them an assuring hope, Lord. That blessed hope that your word speaks of. We need that today in this hour. Lord, have your way in the service this morning. Let your spirit flow. May the spirit of worship fill the air. And God, you said you will inhabit the praise of your people. Inhabit it, Lord. Be with us today. Rain down upon us, God. As we take up our tithes and offerings, touch them in the youth fund. Touch it, Lord. Bless it. Bless the gift and the giver, Lord. And the ones who do not have to give, bless them also. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord. Amen and amen.
'Cause you're walking with me.